Good morning. It's about 1 minute before 7 o'clock right now. WBRU. I say I'm supposed to read this thing about what's happening today. It's Friday, February 24th, and that's the 24th day of 1969, strangely enough. Now 341 days to go. Moon is now between its new phase in the first quarter, which is titillating on a drizzly Friday like this. Evening stars are Venus and Saturn. Up and march around, will you? See, the morning stars today, Jupiter and Mars, and those born today are under the sign of Aquarius. Reminds me of hair, right? American sculptor Paul Whelan Bartlett was born on January 24th, back in 1865. And on this day in history, a couple groovy things happened. Back in 1848, gold discovered in the Sacramento River off near, Coloma, California? Anyway, out there, gold was discovered. And in 1908, the first Boy Scout troop was organized in England by Sir Robert Baden Powell. My name, incidentally, is Jerry Stevens, and I'm here with Don Berns until about 9 this morning. What else happened? In 1946, the United Nations General Assembly voted to set up an Atomic Energy Commission. And back in 1966, President Lyndon Johnson submitted to Congress a record $112.8 billion budget. And back in 66, 117 persons were killed when an Air India jet crashed on Mont Blanc in France. Got a thought for the day, by the way. Scottish economist Adam Smith once said, "The real price of everything, what everything really costs to the man who wants to acquire it, is the toil and trouble of acquiring it." What's happening in the world today? Sounds like the labor theory of economics that went out a couple years ago. 1 minute after 7, if you'd like to set your watch. Now, we've got about 41 degrees in Providence. Doesn't look too good. Occasional rain or drizzle and mild right through tomorrow. It's a grungy morning, believe me. Highest temperature today, 45 to 50 degrees, and the lowest tonight, about 40. Chance of rain is 80% tonight and tomorrow. Well, good morning to you. It's the morning show on WBRU Stereo 95.5. We're here till 9. How about you? Good morning. We said it. 3 minutes after 7 o'clock, Jerry Stevens and Don Berns till 9 of the a.m. on Stereo 95.5. Big Brew.
Good morning, everybody.
Hey, good morning, Don.
Good morning, Jerry. How are you this morning? Gee, it's been a long time, hasn't it?
Yeah, I haven't been up here in a while.
You and I haven't done a show together since, at least yesterday.
Must have been. 6 minutes after 7 o'clock. It's 41 degrees and drizzling now.
All right. Hey,
yeah.
I understand that you went to a real swell wedding yesterday.
Oh, this wedding. I'll tell you more about
it
as the
morning
goes on. All
I know is that I saw a box of cigars in this car this morning, folks.
This wedding, I'll tell you, there's one thing I love about Rhode Island. I'm from around New York City, and we just don't have the Italians down there that you do up here. And
that's
you don't.
For sure. That's for sure.
You don't know what a wedding's like until you go to a good old-fashioned Italian wedding with the 17 generations all right there in the front, and the violin coming between the tables, playing "The More I See You." It's fantastic.
Hey, tell me something, huh?
Yeah.
What? Did I serve pizza at Italian wedding? And we just want Lynn to know that we're taking good care of Jerry for this morning. This is Soulful Strut at 7 minutes past 7.
Morning, everybody. 7 after 7 on the Stevens.
Soulful Strut. Hey, Hey.
Hey, it's 10 hey. Past 7.
Oh, yeah. It's raining outside.
Hey, you know, I didn't know that.
No. The rain is coming in the studios.
Would you please drive carefully, honestly? We got in our little Triumph this morning to come up here, and it was
notice
dark.
Notice how possessive he is. We got in our little Triumph. He owns it.
I'm trying to be polite for you, Don. It was raining and very, very dangerous. And, of course, there are a lot of nuts out on the road who are causing trouble. 41 degrees, and we can...
Nuts on the road?
No, but we can expect rain, Don, today and even parts of tomorrow.
Cashews?
It's going to be that kind. No, I'd prefer pistachios, personally.
Oh, I didn't know. Isn't that great?
Yeah, we got to do news soon, though.
Oops, of course.
Thingy there. You sure this isn't the Stevens scene?
Oh, no, Jerry. Jerry comes to Rhode Island once a year, folks, and it's the Stevens scene.
I guess I used to be. I wonder what happened.
All over the world, east, west, north, and south. News for FM from WBRU-FM in Providence. Good morning, this is the 7:15 report. South Vietnamese Vice President Ky has coupled a call for peace in his nation with a warning that Saigon will not accept it at the price of communist domination. His comment came in Paris as he arrived to coordinate South Vietnamese delegate efforts at the war talks opening tomorrow. It followed by a few hours' communist warning that any war settlement must be formed along strictly communist lines. This just handed in, military spokesmen say communists have shot down a U.S. helicopter ambulance carrying soldiers wounded in the Vietnam War. All seven men aboard were killed, and the plane was downed in the Central Highlands. The spokesman said the helicopter was clearly marked with a large red cross, or I should say large red crosses. The victims were three wounded men and four crewmen. Also on the Vietnam front this morning, heavy fighting is reported as U.S. troops attempt to oust Viet Cong forces from a village 318 miles up the coast from Saigon. The village is surrounded by American soldiers who have called in U.S. bombers and artillery for support. The siege got underway 5 days ago, and in that time, military spokesmen say 26 enemy troops have been killed. More news now, Jerry.
Thank you, Don. President Nixon reported considering his own State of the Union message to Congress. That is a follow-up to the one delivered by former President Johnson. That's the estimate, anyway, of Mr. Nixon's newly appointed economic advisor, Dr. Arthur Berns, who says that if the chief executive decides on the message, it won't be delivered for at least, 30 to 40 days. Don?
Thank you. Speaking about President Nixon, President Nixon's cabinet is complete today, the last man to be confirmed. Interior Secretary Walter Hickel has been approved by the Senate by a vote of 73 to 16. Those 16 dissenting votes were all from conservative-minded Democrats. Correspondent Sam Donaldson on Capitol Hill of the American FM Network talked with Hickel after the confirmation and asked him about those negative votes. We'll have Correspondent Donaldson's report in just a moment. Hickel's a self-made millionaire and former governor of Alaska. He was the only one of Nixon's 12 cabinet appointees who was not unanimously confirmed after perfunctory committee hearings. I think that we have our report now from Correspondent Sam Donaldson.
Do you think the senators were trying to embarrass the Nixon administration, the ones who voted against you?
No, I wouldn't say that. I would say that some of them had an honest doubt. That's their prerogative. And I would hope, too, that show them in the next few months that their doubts were unfounded.
Hickel spoke to newsmen after the Senate's decision was made known, where he commented on the fight over his appointment.
I was fully confident that once my record was made known to the Senate and the Senate Interior and Affairs Committee that I would be confirmed, and I'm happy it's over with. I'm going on with the job, and I think that it will prove out that the confidence that the Senate had in me and that President Nixon has in me, I think it will prove out that all their fears were unfounded.
It has not yet been announced when Hickel would take the oath of office. Jerry?
House Banking Committee Chairman Wright Patman is now critical of Senate approval without debate of Charles Walker as Treasury Undersecretary. Patman termed the unanimous Senate vote for Walker outrageous. He charged that as a former executive vice president of the American Bankers Association, Walker was the leading lobbyist for banking interests. It's 19 minutes after 7 o'clock right now. Another controversial appointment gaining Senate approval was that of California industrialist David Packard to be Deputy Defense Secretary. Opponents raised conflict of interest charges because Packard refused to sell his $300 million worth of stock in an electronics firm which he has founded that now has defense contracts. Currently 41 degrees in Providence, but finally this last item. One of the worst winters on record for wildlife in Minnesota, Wisconsin, Michigan, and the Dakotas poses a problem for sportsmen. Thousands of deers, pheasants, and other game birds and animals are fighting starvation in these snow-covered states. Wildlife officials say this may result in poor hunting next fall for sportsmen and possibly a dip in fishing luck next summer. And my fishing luck can't afford to dip too much more.
And now this item. We got to...
Oh, we have this item.
Yeah.
Oh, I see. 41 degrees in Providence, the humidity 95%, wind northeast to 12 miles an hour, the barometer steady at 30.10. The weather for Providence and vicinity, occasional rain or drizzle and mild through tomorrow, highest temperature today 45 to 50 degrees, the lowest tonight near 40, chance of rain is 80% tonight and tomorrow.
Repeating the present temperature, it's 41 degrees. In Providence, Don Berns and Jerry Stevens for WBRU-FM News. Our next report is the ski report immediately following and then sports at 7:30.
Now, the WBRU Ski Report, brought to you by the three great Alpine ski shops near you, Providence, East Greenwich, and Attleboro. In a moment, today's ski conditions. Now, here's WBRU's ski report.
That was really good, Jim.
Woo!
In Maine today, Big A Ski Area reports 5 to 15 base, fair to good. What does SC stand for? Spring conditions, okay. Pleasant Mountain, packed and granular, 15 to 33 base, good on the upper, good to excellent on the lower. Squaw Mountain, packed 50 to 65 base and good. Sugarloaf, packed 58 to 82 base and excellent. In New Hampshire, we find Cannon Mountain, granular and corn, 18 to 70 base.
That was a cannon.
Fair to good. That's a corn.
No, that was
Cranmore,
a cannon.
Okay. Cranmore, packed and granular, 20 to 44 base, excellent on the upper and good on the lower.
You ever skied on?
No.
Before you get into Cratchit? No?
No. Cratchit Mountain, granular, 8 to 16 base, fair to good on the upper, good on the lower. Loon Mountain.
Oh, yeah, right.
Loon Mountain. Packed 18 to 58 base and good. Bittersill, granular 18 to 40 base and good. Mount Sunapee, granular 8 to 32 base and good. Wildcat, granular 30 to 70 base.
Isn't this interesting, ladies and gentlemen? We'll be back tomorrow with more Pagan Place featuring Don Berns.
In Vermont today, Mount Ascutney as frozen.
I beg your good insight there.
Yeah, well, that's all right. Bear spots on Mount Ascutney today.
I didn't know that.
15 to 30 base and fair. I'm supposed to be the straight man, folks.
Right. That's it.
No, it shouldn't be. Press it again.
Oh.
Stupid cartridge machine. Dutch Hill, call our engineer, will you? Dutch Hill, granular, 28 to 40 base, fair to good. Glen Ellen, packed 49 to 93 base, excellent in the upper, good to excellent in the lower.
Yeah, that's good for people who don't ski.
It's good for people who are just getting up, too. They're wondering what we're doing.
Morning.
Frozen granular and icy, 15 to 32 base, fair to good. J Peak, packed 46 to 48 base, and excellent with them. Sugar Bush, frozen granular and packed 50 to 66 base. Good to excellent. Let's check nearby Massachusetts and Rhode Island, and then we'll see.
It's cold and windy in Massachusetts. Cold and windy.
Nothing's really good. Like
it's 24 minutes after 7 o'clock, 41 degrees in Providence right now. Shirley, go ahead. Hurry up,
will you? I can't hear myself. Turn my microphone louder. That's better. Hello. In Massachusetts today, Brody Mountain has granular 20 to 42 base, good to excellent. And Jiminy Peak has granular 6 to 20 base, fair to good in the upper, good in the lower. Klein Innsbruck, which is pretty close to us, has corn.
Yeah.
22 base, fair to good. Here in Rhode Island, Pine Top reports granular 10 to 12 base, fair to good. And the Weather Bureau outlook for the area says cloudy and mild. It's Friday, that's today, with a chance of some light drizzle or light rain over the region continuing till tonight. High temperature today near 40 or in the 40s in the ski country with some thawing, so it doesn't look like it's very good skiing, I would say.
Thank you. Incidentally, if you do
have
a
thing here.
I have to push that again?
Yeah.
Yeah, well, just before I do that, if you have any questions over your own favorite ski area, you can give us a call anytime.
Our number
is 863-2892. Out of town, don't call at all.
Ski Report has been brought to you by Alpine Ski Shops, 1220 Elmwood Avenue, Providence, 754 Main Street, East Greenwich, and 15 North Main Street, Attleboro. Your complete ski centers. Listen Thursday through Saturday at 7:20 and 8:20 a.m. and 4:30 p.m. for Ski Report, a feature presentation of WBRU-FM.
Thank you very much, Don. Tune in again tomorrow for more exciting ski reports with Donald Berns.
Well, you can tune in again in an hour if you really want.
Now we're going to have to interrupt this titillating talk for a record. Dionne Warwick, good morning, everyone. 26 minutes after 7. I'm an Adam Tiger. 28 minutes after 7 o'clock on WBRU 95 and a half. We're going to sneak in another record before Don Berns starts.
How can you do that?
Oh, we can do it.
I got a mojo for wayward boys and girls.
WBRU FM Sports.
Good morning, everybody. It's 7:31. In the sports this morning, the Boston Bruins strengthened their hold on first place in the National Hockey League's Eastern Division last night, even though they only managed to tie the Red Wings 2-2 in Detroit. With an assist from the Oakland Seals to beat second-place Montreal, the Bruins moved out to a 5-point edge over the Canadiens in the standings. The tie preserved Boston's second-longest unbeaten streak and extended it to 12 games. Stop drinking coffee in the background. Only one player on each team was involved in the scoring, as Ken Hodge collected the Bruins' two goals, and Frank Malevich hit twice for the hot Red Wings. Hodge, who has now scored two goals in each of his three appearances in Detroit this season, fired in both in a span of 2.5 minutes in the second period. Malevich had put Detroit ahead 1-0 at the 18-minute mark of the first period. He collected the tying goal just before the 2-minute mark of the final period.
He is hot.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Frank, he is amazing. All right, now, moving on to other Boston sports action last night. The battle for second place in the NBA Eastern Division resumes tonight at the Boston Garden when the Celtics tip off against the Philadelphia 76ers. The 76ers are one game ahead of the Celtics, running three games in back of the pace-setting Baltimore Bullets. Boston will be out to improve its position when they chase their fourth straight win over... over the defending Eastern Division champions this season. The Celtics have won 10 of their last 13 starts, but they dropped their last two games, costly losses to Baltimore and Chicago. The Celts will be without the services of their backcourt spark plug Larry Siegfried. Larry Siegfried is still nursing a 9-stitch gash in his right index finger, suffered a week ago in San Francisco. Will Chamberlain stepped on him. Jerry, you have some other scores in the NBA and NHL.
Well, not really, but the National Basketball Association took a breather last night. A heavy schedule lined up for tonight. I knew it. Los Angeles is at Atlanta tonight. New York at Detroit, and watch those amazing Knickerbockers go. Chicago at Phoenix, San Diego at San Francisco.
How are they going to do without Cassie Russell, by the way?
It's going to be rough, but it quite frankly, it might give Bradley a chance to come into his own. Bradley has been basically a second and third quarter player. They've been using him fourth quarter on some tight situations, and this might give Bill the chance he hasn't had since he, of course, led Princeton into the Nationals about 3-4 years ago. The American Basketball Association, who cares? They're so bad, right? The Houston Mavericks of the American Basketball Association have a new general manager, which titillates us all. And in the National Hockey League, it was active last night with a heavy schedule of games. Ron Ellis scored twice in the second period to give the Toronto Maple Leafs a 3-2 win over the St. Louis Blues. It was the first time this season that Toronto was able to win in the St. Louis Arena. In other action, let's see, New York beat Los Angeles 3-1. Oakland slapped Montreal with a 5-3 loss. Minnesota defeating Pittsburgh 3-1. Chicago and Philadelphia tied at 2-2. And the NHL is idle tonight. The American Hockey League was idle, but there are three games on tap tonight. On tap. Hershey at Baltimore, Providence at Buffalo, and Cleveland at Rochester. 24 before 8 o'clock.
Why don't you tell the people about
I was going to tell them this
brown
item.
Hockey.
Yeah.
Well, you don't have to stick to format in the sports report.
It's returning to action again, you know. We're playing St. Nick's this coming Saturday night. There wasn't a game for the last 2 weeks because of
for
exams.
For those of you wondering who we are, it's Brown University.
Didn't I say that?
Well, no, I did.
Anyway... Brown University is a game against the smooth-skating St. Nick's Club, which is made up of former collegiate hockey players. It's a hockey club down in New York City. It's Saturday night at Miet Auditorium. All the action, of course, here at 95.5. 7:45 this Saturday, the Jim Fullerton Show kicks it all off. Apparently, he's changed the whole lineup, and he'll tell how and why. Then at 7:55, all the play-by-play begins with Jim Shantz and Terry Chapman, a former Bruins star himself. And for every Brown hockey game all season long, join WBRU 95.5, the Brown Man Sport Network, with music for the FM generation, Music 67.
No, come on. The defensive end Jerry Philbin of the New York Jets has been named Rhode Island Athlete of the Year for 1968 by the state's sports writers and sportscasters. They didn't consult me. Philbin, who helped the Jets to the American Football League Championship and a surprise victory over the Baltimore Colts in the Super Bowl, will be honored at the annual meeting of Words Unlimited on February 10th. It sounds like this show. And finally, Broadway Joe Namath of the World Champion Jets was honored by the Professional Football Writers of America.
I'd love to see him get stomped.
I like Joe.
He is such a good player, but I'd love to see... I was hoping someone like Bubba Smith would just drill him about 4 feet into the ground.
You know, I used to think that about Cassius Clay named Muhammad Ali.
Yeah.
Or Muhammad Ali named Cassius Clay. But I really like Joe Namath. I even like his cockiness. I think it's really amazing.
Something else. New England college basketball last night. Northeastern 68, Massachusetts 64. Vermont 99,
morning,
Connecticut
John.
87. John Kennedy is about ready to go on the air soon, isn't he? Bentley 97. And Newark, hey, that's where I live. Newark 94. Go ahead, Don.
I think that'll about do it for sports. Sports report will be at 8:30 if we survive that long, and we'll be back in 9 minutes.
With some more talk and news and other interesting things.
Stay tuned to 95.5 all day for complete and current FM sports.
Hit it, Jerry.
No, hey, Don, we need a fanfare. Could I have a trumpet fanfare? We're going to play a record, huh? Sit down, you're rocking the boat.
All right.
Beware, Don. It's coming.
What?
It's coming. Beware.
Oh.
21 before 8 o'clock on WBRU's morning show. And,
you can play that. That's nice. Listen.
Thank you. 21 minutes before 8 o'clock
My
on
God.
WBRU. Hey, look who... From downtown Providence, in comes Wendy South. Hi, Wendy. Oh,
good morning, Jared.
Good morning. Oh,
it's nice to see you after all these
years.
Give
you about 10 minutes to get your hand out of there. Go ahead.
What? Now stop that. I have the weather forecast for those of our listeners who would like to hear it. This
I
morning.
Also notice you have our chief engineer wrapped under your left bicep.
Yes. Would you please say good morning, chief engineer?
Good morning.
Sorry, chief. Go ahead, Wendy. How about the weather here?
You got the weather. Got a turntable problem over there.
Get him out of here.
Quiet. Occasional rain or drizzle and mild through tomorrow. High temperature today, 45 to 50 degrees. Mm. And the lower tonight, near 40.
Easily. Oh, well, go ahead.
Right now, it's 41 degrees. And the wind is out of the northeast at 12 miles an hour, because I like to give the wind because I'm windy.
A little bit of a pun. That's wonderful. Yes. Yeah, go on.
I don't like your puns.
Keep reading. Well, leave her alone. Will you? Let Wendy finish. Will you let Wendy finish?
I'm finished. That's it. Thank you.
Was that it?
That's all.
That's all you had to say.
That's all.
I got to fix the
get him out of here.
That's toe-tapping music, isn't it? To get you up in the morning.
Sinuses, doesn't it? It's 17 minutes.
You were blowing your nose in that handkerchief for 3 hours.
It's a table. 17 minutes before 8 o'clock on WBRU 95.5. Burns and Stevens, till 9. Station will never be
the same. I like the sound of that. No, Stevens and Burns. Sounds more like Clavin.
Stevens and Burns, till 9. If you got any comments, send them to Boss, B-O-S-S, care of WBRU in Providence. That's
I'll get
Burns.
Them and tear them up. It's as simple as that.
Are you ready, Don? We've got to go into our little routine. A one, and a two, and a one, two, three.
We are the Joy Boys of radio.
Hello, 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 hello. We come to entertain you. Well, don't you know? He doesn't listen to Clavin Finn. Hello, 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 hello.
It
isn't WICE, huh?
No, they don't. They're on the AM band.
Oh, one of the...
I heard that something's happening down there.
Is that right?
Yes.
Hey, you know what I heard? That starting Monday, something's going to happen here.
Oh, yeah.
You think they're going to let us do the morning show every morning?
After today, we'll be lucky if we're let back into Rhode Island.
Snowball's chance
something
in hell.
Something told
right?
me it's Good morning, everybody, from all over southern New England. We have the latest news. At 7:45 on WBRU-FM in Providence, Secretary of the Navy designate John Chafee admits the Pueblo affair will eventually wind up on his desk, but he says for the present he does not want to become involved. The former Rhode Island governor made the remark in response to questioning yesterday by Senator Peter Dominick of Colorado at Senate hearings on Chafee's nomination. Dominick wanted assurances the Senate Armed Services Committee would be given full data concerning the capture of the USS Pueblo and the subsequent investigation. Jerry?
Yeah, two ski-masked men have forced their way into a North Kingstown home. This was last evening. They slugged the owner and stole a rifle and shotgun. Police said 62-year-old William Allen of 180 School Street told them the two men forced their way into his home about 9 o'clock. They demanded money. He said one of the men was carrying a .38 caliber revolver. Allen, who lives in an isolated farmhouse, told WBRU News he tried to scare the men off with an empty .22 caliber rifle. But it didn't work. One of the men grabbed it while the other hit him with a blackjack. Don?
Thank you, Jerry. The Attorney General's office has filed applications in Bristol County Superior Court in Taunton to have 81 pinball machines seized in county raids last year turned over to the state. In the applications, the state yesterday named Martin Ferrero of New Bedford as the owner of the machines, valued at $100,000. Last July, Ferrero pleaded guilty to 91 gaming and conspiracy charges, covering more than 5 years as operator of a pinball gambling operation in Bristol County. By statute, property that is forfeited is ordered by the court to be sold, with the proceeds going to the county treasurer. Jerry?
Thank you. There's something about Rhode Island news, because a silver chain more than a mile long and $20,000 worth of jewelry items have been reported missing from a Providence jewelry firm. Police told WBRU the missing items reported yesterday after an inventory at the Anson Company. Officials of the firm told police the loss could have occurred any time since the company's last inventory back in July, and that's tight management, huh?
A Bristol man faces arraignment today in Providence on a murder charge. 28-year-old Anthony Caraturo is charged with the shooting of 27-year-old Anthony Ferrier of Warren, who died yesterday of injuries he received on December 19th. Caraturo has been held at the Adult Correctional Institution in lieu of $25,000 bail. The Trident, a research vessel of the University of Rhode Island Graduate School of Oceanography, leaves Narragansett today for a 91-day cruise in the Caribbean Sea. Officials say the vessel will conduct research during the cruise. The Trident is expected to return to its home port on May 5th. Jerry?
Two masked men, one armed with a gun, were foiled in an apparent hold-up attempt by a New York diamond merchant. Police said Joseph Reinkauer found the two men last night hiding in a closet in his room at the Biltmore Hotel in Providence. Police said the men fled after the gem dealer slammed the door in their faces and then ran from the room yelling, and we quote, "Hold up, hold up." They said the two men escaped down an emergency staircase. Reinkauer, who owns a wholesale diamond house in New York City, said nothing was missing from his room. He said all his valuable gems were in the hotel safe.
In nearby Massachusetts, former House Speaker Robert Quinn has succeeded Undersecretary of State Elliot Richardson as State Attorney General. Quinn was elected by his former colleagues in the Massachusetts legislature by a 184-65 vote on a secret ballot. Quinn, a Democrat, was opposed by Representative Robert Belmont of Framingham, whom the GOP put up as a token candidate. House Democratic leader David Bartley succeeded Quinn as Speaker of the Massachusetts House. Bartley overpowered House Republican leader Sidney Curtis of Sheffield by a 163-60 roll call vote to become, at 33, one of the youngest speakers in Massachusetts history. Jerry?
Don, this is interesting. The oldest active carrier in the Navy is expected today to be decommissioned soon and turned over to the mothball fleet. Poor guy's been carrying the plague for about 14 years. Sources say the Quonset-based carrier Essex, being retired to the Reserve Fleet facility in Philadelphia as part of the Department of Defense economic cutback. Navy officials say they have no information on a possible replacement for the Essex, but there are reports that another carrier may be assigned to take her place. It's almost out of time here. Don, do you have another one there?
I was going to say, now, this item.
Oh!
Tires are a lot better than they used to be, but a flat is still one of the most common emergencies a driver ever has to face. People who drive a lot, like professional truck drivers, know that, so they train themselves to follow these rules on flat tires. Grip the wheel firmly, foot off the gas, let the car slow down before using brakes, pull off the road. Nobody likes a flat tire, but we can learn to live with them safely.
Yeah. The weather?
Weather.
I was going to talk about the flat, I knew. 41 degrees in Providence. Occasional rain or drizzle and mild through tomorrow. Highest temperature today, 45 to 50 degrees. The lowest tonight, near 40. Chance of rain is 80% tonight, and tomorrow it's 41 degrees right now. Barometer holding steady. It doesn't look too good out there. 9 minutes before 8 o'clock, and you're going to do this thing?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, thank you.
Repeating the present temperature, it's 41 degrees in Providence, Don Berns and Jerry Stevens.
Jerry who?
Jerry Stevens.
Oh.
And our next report will be at 8 o'clock with headlines.
Again?
What was that about a mile-long chain?
All we ever do is news.
Well, people want to be informed as they're getting up in the morning. Don't you want to be informed while you're getting up in the morning?
It's called Windy, and it's done by the association, of course. 1 minute before 8 o'clock on WBRU FM, 95.5 in Providence. Taking a quick look at our community bulletin board, the Junior League of Providence, Rhode Island, presenting a fun-filled evening of musical entertainment entitled Folly's Bazaar. It'll be Friday and Saturday evenings, January 31st, February 1st, 8:30 o'clock p.m. in the East Providence High School Auditorium. Proceeds from this event benefiting the League's Community Trust Fund. You can make reservations by calling 421-8263. Any news or notes of interest to the greater southern New England area, just send them in on a postcard or a letter or something to the WBRU's Community Bulletin Board. WBRU, Providence, Rhode Island, 02912. That's Don Berns. That's our engineer. I thought it was Don Berns. Well, you get out from under the turntable. We've got news headlines coming up next, and then quarter past, we have news from ABC FM Network, and then at 20 past, we have the ski report, and at 8:30, we have sports, just to know how much we're going to talk. I love it.
Good morning, it's 8 o'clock. Here are the latest headlines. U.S. military spy news at 8:01. Our next report from the American FM Network at 8:15.
Thank you very much, Don.
You're welcome, Jim.
As you know, we have news about every hour here on WBRU, and we're going to keep having it every hour until one of them gets it right. I heard that on the Big W. I thought it might be. I wonder if you'd like to hear what my aunt said.
It really isn't time, Chair. I think we got to play.
Well, I think that what she said would have been interesting, having been locked in a fantastic ship going from Africa to New York City with 1,400 Copa girls to form the new Copacabana dance girl line.
You really socked it over there, didn't you?
I didn't know that. Four minutes after 8 o'clock. Good morning, everybody.
Look at the mini skirt on that girl.
It's not a girl, it's a guy.
Providence, anything can happen.
Must be from RISD. 42 degrees right now in Providence, up another degree, but the forecast hasn't changed appreciably. Still going to be raining all day today and most of tomorrow, so drive very carefully, you hear?
Fortunately, it's raining right now.
Is it really?
Looking outside our studio window.
Perhaps I should put my top up. 4 minutes after 8 o'clock on 95.5 WBRU-FM. Don't forget Brown University hockey coming up this Saturday night.
Right, I won't forget it.
Game time, 7:55. Brown returning to action after a two-week layoff for exams.
That's right. That's right. Don't forget Brown University hockey. I'm going to be doing all the play-by-play action right here on WBRU.
You're not going to be doing all the play-by-play.
Yeah, well, that's why my name is Jim Schnatz, folks, because I could say Brown University.
It's titillating, I'm sure. That's by Cher and Cher alike. What the heck? 8 minutes after 8 o'clock.
I just want to report that I've been out on the highways and byways this morning. It is kind of crowded going north toward Providence on 95 and east toward Providence on 195 and south toward Providence on 95. And it seems that everything kind of graduates toward Providence, you see. I've been out getting traffic reports for all your listeners.
Thank you. I'm glad. That reminds me of something that I've wanted to say for a long time. Size 6.5. you don't know how long I've wanted to do that, man.
It's 8 minutes past 8 o'clock, 42 degrees. Good morning, everybody. Burns and Stevens for a song this morning until 9, and then Adam Blistein will come in. The old Hambone himself is going to sock it to you until about 10:30 when Barbara Birch returns for
is that
opening
right?
night.
Barbara Birch.
I was going to say Barbara, if you're listening this morning, it's a shame. It's really a shame, Barbara, but since you've left us, well, my eggs just don't taste the same without you.
That's beautiful, Don.
That's a fabulous spark, Barge.
It's 11 minutes after 8 o'clock on WBRU's morning show. Good morning. Something new's happening to Big Bruce. Starts Monday, right?
No, it starts Sunday, but we're not going to tell anybody.
We don't know what it is, but something's happening.
I'm the program director, and I don't know what it is.
Yeah, but that's because there's a revolt. Oh. There's a palace revolution, you dumb.
Well, Dr. Strange Voice is at it again. Love this song by the Turtles, 11 minutes past 8.